guys, it's Kelly, welcome back. In today's video, I'm gonna be chatting about some gimmicky makeup items. So products that just kind of have something, a little bit of an interesting twist to them. And I'm gonna be letting you know whether I think the gimmick is worth it, or it's just kind of a gimmick just to be a gimmick and doesn't actually add any value or make the product better. So before we jump in, I want to address what is perhaps very obvious. My eye is very irritated right now, which is why I'm not wearing any eye makeup. I have had some irritation in it for the past day or two, so I haven't been wearing eye makeup, and I did have some videos pre-filmed, but I had to get back to filming today, so that's why I just have on face makeup and no eye makeup. If you can see a little bit of redness in my eye, that is why. I don't have like pink eye or anything like that, but my eye is just irritated over there. So I won't be wearing eye makeup in today's video, and maybe not in tomorrow's video, and maybe even the next day. It just is gonna depend on how my eye is feeling. But I'm a little bummed about it because you guys know I've been having so much fun playing with different looks and different eye shadow techniques and just having a lot of fun with my eye makeup. So it was a little bit sad today to not do any eyeshadow. But I do also love this look. I think it's really fresh for like spring and summer of a really light face. I'm just wearing like a tinted moisturizer. I'm wearing the Mary Luminizer on my cheeks and just something light and natural like this. So I'm not so mad about it, but you know I wanted to be playing with eyeshadow today, so. And I have had a ton of requests to film a few of the eye looks that I wore in videos last week, and I really wanted to get those filmed today or tomorrow so they could be up this week, but that's just not gonna happen right now, but stay tuned. I do want to get those filmed for you guys, but without further ado, let's go ahead and hop into the video. First, I want to kick things off with a gimmick that I feel like might not be a gimmick for much longer because I'm starting to see other brands do this as well. I'm talking about water self-tanners. So this one is the self-tanner by TAN-LUXE. I mentioned to you guys a while ago that I was using this, and I also shared this on my Instagram, and so many of you guys sent me messages, left me comments, like, when you figure out whether or not you like that, you need to let us know because I'm so intrigued by it. And I also have this product. I shared this on my Instagram stories, and again, I had a lot of messages from you guys saying, you need to let us know what you think about that. So let me explain, let me back up a little bit. So this is called the water. It's literally a water that self-tans you. I mean, it of course has other ingredients in it. It's not just pure water, but it smells like apples, and you spritz this all over your body, rub it in with a mitt, and then it darkens your skin just like a self-tanner, any other self-tanner would. This one is a little bit different. This is called the face. They're illuminating self-tan drops. So basically, you can drip these into any of your skincare. Don't drip it like right into the bottle, but if you put a few pumps of whatever moisturizer, serum, whatever you want into your hand, put two to four drops of this in as well, and then apply your skincare products like normal, and that will tan up your face. So first I want to share my thoughts on the water. If you guys follow me on Instagram and you saw my stories a few months ago, you'll know that I had a really bad experience with this the first time that I used it because my hands were very dry. I put lotion on them beforehand like I always do, but the tanner still really took to my hands. So what I've learned since then is that I, of course, always put moisturizer on my hands, but I never spray this product directly on my hands. I spray it throughout the rest of my arm, and then whatever is left on my mitt, I just rub over my hands a little bit. Like, do not put a lot of this on your hands. Do not do a whole pump on your hands, or it's gonna be bad news. But if you use the technique that I just said, where you just kind of swipe whatever is left over your hands, I actually find this to look the most natural on my hands out of any self-tanner that I've tried. And my hands are a little bit lighter than the rest of my body right now because your hands always fade the fastest because you wash them all the time. But I applied this 5 days ago, and I still feel like I have decent color. It's of course faded. It's not as tan as when I first applied it, but I feel like this lasts pretty long actually. Now, the first time I used this, I didn't think I got a lot of color payoff, and I realized that you have to apply a decent amount of this. I was trying like thinking like three spritz was enough for my chest, and it's not. I would recommend about 6 to 9 spritz for different areas of your body depending on how large they are. So you'll get used to it and realize how much you have to spray. But the first time I hardly applied any, and I was like, this didn't tan me at all. But now I actually really, really like this stuff. And at first I thought, you know, that's kind of a silly gimmick. But the reason that I appreciate this so much is because you don't have to worry about color guard. And you don't know what color guard is, it's when you apply your soft tanner and it's a kind of a dark brown shade or sometimes even a green shade, and it kind of shows you where the color is. Now that's nice if you're first getting into self tanning and you need a little help applying the product, but if you're a little more experienced with self tanning, you don't necessarily need that. And for me, I would always get so frustrated because I hated having to wash color guard off. I hated having that on my body because it felt gross, and I only could apply self tanner at night. I can apply this whenever I want. If I want to apply this in the middle of the day and just get tanner throughout the day, I can because there's no color guard. So, and you don't have to worry about like waking up and immediately getting in the shower. I'm a nighttime shower, so I don't always want to have to do that. So for that reason, it's convenient. I actually would really recommend this. This is on the pricier side. It's $47, but let me grab actually. Okay, I had to go grab this. This is the Loving Tan Mousse, and this gives you 4 fluid ounces, and this is $40. This is $47, and you're getting 6.76 fluid ounces. So this is gonna cost you more up front, but it's a better value for how much product you're getting. It's hard to say though, because this is a mousse and this is a water, so I don't know how quickly, I will use them up as quickly as each other. But I've been using this for, I think, at least 2 months now, and I've only used this much. However, I will say, when I do self-tan, I am such a cheater. I will just self-tan my chest and my arms, and I will skip the rest of my body unless I know for a fact that I'm going to be wearing a crop top or shorts, because it has not been shorts weather here, so I've been skipping my legs. So that's probably part of the reason I haven't used it all, but I do feel like that bottle would last a long time. Now the face. I really, really like this. First of all, it smells good. I don't even know how I would explain the scent. Kind of perfumey, so if you are very sensitive to smells, you might not like it, but it smells fresh and clean. And I've used this 6 times, I'm pretty sure. 6, maybe even 7 times. You cannot even tell that I've used this. And they recommend between 2 to 4 drops at once. And the first time that I used it, I went with 2 drops just because I was nervous. And I actually got pretty dark. And a few of you guys messaged me on Instagram saying you'd tried it, and you guys warned me. You're like, be careful, because a little bit goes a long way, and it really does. So if you want to get really dark on your face, you can put in 4 drops, but even 2 to 3 drops actually gives me a pretty nice tan. Now this doesn't last as long as the water does on your body, but it makes sense because you wash your face all the time. You're always putting product on it, rubbing things on it, so it's face tanners never last as long for me. The face soft tanner that I was using before was from TAN-LUXE. It's their Color Correct CC Soft Tanning Face Lotion, and I liked this, but I felt like it would fade after 1 day. Like the next day I would have nice tan to my face, but I would have to reapply it so often, and it was frustrating me because I felt like I couldn't do my nighttime skincare because I was using this, and I didn't want it to affect it. So with this, you can just put it right into your skincare without a worry. So this is something I would highly recommend. I actually think this is such a unique concept. So I'm going to say neither of these, let me back up. Both of these are gimmicky, but I think they're gimmicks that work. And I feel like this is going to be the new way of self-tanning, because I know Saint Tropez just came out with a self-tanning water. Theirs is different though. Theirs is still a mousse and it still like pumps up, but it's clear. And I know there's another brand that just came to Sephora. These are both at Sephora, by the way. And it's the brand Isle of Paradise, and they also have a self-tanning water. So I want to try that one next. I kind of think this might be the new way to tan. All right, for my next gimmick, I want to talk about this guy. It is from skyn. It's the Glacial Spray Lotion. Now, I've had this video idea planned for a while now. I knew I wanted to film something about gimmicky products, and I saw this pop up on my Octoly store, and I was like, I think I need to add that to the video, because I don't think I've ever heard of any other true spray lotion. I know we have moisturizing primers, moisturizing waters that you spritz onto your face, but this is actually a lotion in a spray bottle and a face lotion. So I was interested to try it out, and I wasn't sure how it was gonna work because lotions tend to be kind of on the thicker side. So I thought, you know, is this going to spray through this container? And I don't think it sprays that well. Let me try and show you on camera. I don't know if you could see that. It was mostly a fine mist, but in the middle there was like one very prominent glob. And that's what I noticed on my skin. The first few times that I sprayed this, it was really, really patchy, but the more I used the nozzle, it started to get a little bit more on the fine side. but I still don't feel like this is a fine enough mist to use. Personally, I don't really like this. Now, I do think that it makes sense for someone who maybe is just getting into skincare, is not used to applying a moisturizer every day, is maybe a little bit lazier with their skincare routine, doesn't want to go through that effort. It is very easy to but just know you will still have to rub it in. So do I recommend this for someone who is like a big skincare junkie? Do I think this is going to change your skincare game? No. But if maybe you need a little motivation to apply a moisturizer and this might make it easier for you, it might be something to look into. I do think it's a nice moisturizer. It smells like sunscreen. It doesn't have SPF in it, but it still has that scent. You know what though? I actually just thought of this. I might use this on my body because I don't know that I would finish this up on my face, but this might be a cool idea to use on my body because I'm going to rub it in anyways. So that might be a way to check out. I'm going to try that. All right, now let's talk about this guy, very popular at the moment. I did review this in my last best and worst new makeup releases. So if you didn't catch that video, I'll leave it linked in the description box. It's the new BECCA Hydra Mist Set and Refresh Powder. So the gimmick behind this, and it's not as gimmicky as some of these other products, but this is marketed as being 50% water, which I don't know that I've ever seen another setting powder that's half water. And it's such a bizarre feeling when you apply it onto your skin because it actually does feel wet and it's a little bit scary because you think, okay, am I about to mess up all my makeup? It feels like you didn't, feels like you have a wet brush and you're about to like streak up your makeup. But it applies kind of just like a normal powder. Now, I mentioned in the video, I do like this. I think it's a good powder. But do I think that it performs any different than my other powders? Not necessarily. It's a tad bit more smoothing than some others, but I don't find it to be incredibly hydrating. And I'm saying that as someone with kind of dry under eyes, I don't find that it does anything more than other under eye setting powders. So with this one, I do think it's a good product, but it's not something I personally would repurchase. I'm gonna use it up, but I do think it's kind of gimmicky. And the final product that I want to talk about is a foam dry shampoo. Now, this is another one that I feel like a lot of brands are starting to come up with, and maybe this will be the new thing. I want to say that Way also has one of these, and maybe, I might be making this up, but I want to say Samantha said she didn't like it. Has anyone else tried another foam dry shampoo? Because this one is from Amika. They sent this to me. It's called the Phantom Hydrating Dry Shampoo Foam. And first, let me say, it smells delicious. This is, I love when my dry shampoos smell nice because even when I have dirty, nasty hair, I'm like, at least my hair smells clean and I can pretend that it's clean. But this comes out, let me show you, let me take my ring off, take my rings off so I can show you this. It really is a foam. It's like you are applying a mousse into your hair. And it's a good thing I save this for last because I'm about to just show, I'll do a demonstration right here for you guys. So comes out like that. Picked it up off my pants, comes off like that. So I actually have it in my hair already, and let me just point that out, that my hair I still think looks a little greasy right now, and I have applied this. So what I do, I go like that, put it in my hair, and it's weird because you can probably see it right now on camera. I didn't apply that much. I usually put in a little bit more than that if I hadn't already put it in my hair today, but it makes your hair a little bit wet at first. And what I do is I'll sit here for a few minutes until it dries, and then I will go through with a comb and comb through my hair. Because the first time that I used this, I put a lot more in my hair than that, and I put it like all in this way, and I looked in the mirror and I was like, my hair looks so much greasier than it did 2 minutes ago, because this really does make your hair wet and it kind of sticks together because it is kind of like a mousse. But if you wait for it to dry and you brush through it, it does make your hair look a little bit better. Is this the most effective dry shampoo I have ever used? No. I would say it's one of the least. And I don't mean, let me back that up. When I say the least effective, it makes it seem like it doesn't do anything. It definitely makes my hair less greasy. But it makes my hair just a little bit less greasy. And that's kind of what they're going for. They describe this as a dry shampoo for someone who doesn't really like dry shampoos, because it's not like a powdery product or one that you spray into your hair that makes your hair really matte and there's like no oil at all. This makes your hair look kind of shiny, which almost gives it that greasy look to it. So is this something I'd recommend if you have 7-day hair? Mm-mm. maybe second day hair if you just want a little freshening up, but it's not the most effective dry shampoo I've ever tried. It just does a little bit. So if you're someone who doesn't have super greasy hair, maybe if your hair is very fine and you just want to kind of clean it up a little bit and still keep that shine without your hair looking kind of matte and dull the way other dry shampoos can, this is a product I think you might like. But if you're just like a dry shampoo junkie and you love dry shampoos and you like that they really dry out the oils, this might disappoint you a little bit. So I don't wash my hair very often, 1 to 2 times a week. That's all. And I just like live by dry shampoo and just powders in my hair. So for me, I like to use baby powder quite a bit. So if I have like third day hair, it's starting to get a little bit greasy. If I put some baby powder in, my hair is good for another day or two before I have to put in more baby powder because it just kind of soaks up all the oils. With this, if I put this in today, I'm gonna have to put more in tomorrow and more in the next day because it just doesn't soak up the oils the way a powder does. So that's definitely one thing to keep in mind. But if you don't like the idea of powders, this could be something for you. This is another product that personally I would not repurchase just kind of based on my preferences. I like it enough to use it up, but I don't feel like I would buy it again. So I hope that this video was fun for you guys to kind of chat about some of the new gimmicky products to hit the market. If you've tried any of these or similar products or other gimmicky products, let us know in the comment section down below. I would love to hear your experience. If you enjoyed this video, let me know by giving a thumbs up, and I'll see you guys tomorrow at 9 a.m. Eastern. Bye!